Hi everyone, thanks so much for tuning in to the Therapeutic Skin Coach YouTube channel. Today I want to talk about a couple of things. Number one, I have ventured into my practice sort of not knowing how I was going to get labeled. For me, being a licensed esthetician was always just going to be sort of enough. Like, I have a license to touch and feel your face and help you throughout whatever skin condition you're going through. However, when I carefully started to curate the products that I wanted to hold in my space, I realized that I was gravitating towards more green beauty products, and whatever that sort of encompasses for you is what, you know, was kind of attracting my clientele to me. So I wanted to express today what green beauty means to me, and also kind of share a little bit more of why I tend to want to steer away from most labels, especially when it comes to the industry that I'm in, the realm that I'm in, the community that I'm in, and why. It's very millennial of me to want to steer away from all these labels, but I do think that I owe my audience and my listeners a proper explanation of how I would identify. So to start, what green beauty means to me, when I think about it and when I'm really in tune with my clients who advocate for green beauty, I think about it not just in terms of ingredients that are sourced organically or they're wild harvested, so collected from nature. I think about green beauty as an entire platform of love in which every aspect of the creation of a product is carefully thought out, how it will affect the consumer, so the person who is usually using the product on themselves, their environment, so the people that it could potentially affect. For example, like a mother, if she's wearing something on her shoulder, like a sunscreen, and she has a child that touches it, will it transfer over? Will it be safe for them as well? And then also how the ingredients and the product themselves affect the environment. I have always grown up to be an environmentalist. I wouldn't necessarily say I'm like a perfect environmentalist in the sense that I'm completely zero waste, but I am very mindful of it, and I do my best to make sure that my decisions are conscious enough towards not harming the earth, our environment, in any sort of element. And those decisions impact me in my daily life, but they also are a huge factor as to why I've decided to create the practice that I have and the way I have. So the reason why I am so attracted to a lot of these brands that consider themselves all natural, green beauty, and the best way I like to describe them is as non-toxic, is because it's just very much in alignment with my values. It's in alignment with how I feel on a day-to-day basis and what I want to experience for my own self. And I just don't want to be hypocritical and, you know, advocate for something that isn't something I would use personally. So the brands that I am committed to and often recommend, I find have such a beautiful brand founder story. So it is curated from love because the founder or the founders felt the need to create something that was going to be safe for them because they either experienced an issue or a problem in their life where they were sick, or someone that is a loved one, it was experiencing an issue in which they needed a safer alternative in a product. Oftentimes these entrepreneurs, these creators, they come up with these types of solutions because it is not accessible to them or their loved ones right away. So they're like, okay, here's a problem. Here's what I'm going to do to fix it. And I really admire that. I felt like I sort of dove into that myself as a facialist because I would have all of these clients who were pregnant or experiencing an illness, whether they were in remission from cancer or just experiencing something that was really traumatic to the system where their immunity was already very low. I didn't want to add in any ingredients I didn't feel safe for them to use long term or to even use within like the hour treatment I was doing it. So sometimes I would just find myself not even recommending products and just almost recommending self-care practices for my clientele instead of you buy this serum packed full of like artificial this and that. How about you go home and meditate a little bit, journal out what you're feeling, try to see if you can get to the root of what might be causing that that self-confidence issue for you. Because yes, maybe your skin is communicating something or maybe experiencing an inflammatory condition at the moment, but why is that really affecting you in a way where you are low self-worth, low confidence? And you know, I think just kind of shifting that mindset is way more impactful to me and to the client than selling them something that I'm not even sure is going to work for them in their routine and in their day-to-day life. So that's a little bit about my personal interpretation of green beauty. I know that other people have different interpretations, and I think that's great. I just find that my particular way of seeing that sort of industry might be slightly different, and I do think that it is important to clarify. I also don't necessarily identify as holistic, and it's not because I don't believe in holistic modalities. I certainly do, and I would love to be 100% there. However, I do use different modalities to help enhance the efficacy of the products that I use, because having previously worked with conventional forms of skincare, their results are so much more impactful and quick for a client. So if they're looking to sort of achieve that same goal while using non-toxic ingredients, sometimes it's just a matter of pairing them with the right modality. I don't believe in over-treating the skin, such as like, you know, adding things that are going to compromise your barrier or compromise the pH of your skin without pairing it with something that's going to really calm, soothe, restore the skin. So oftentimes people come to me, they want me to get really aggressive with extractions, really aggressive with exfoliation, and potentially just avoid the conversation of self-care and internal care altogether because they just want a fast, quick result. That's not necessarily what I'm about either. I want the skin to self-heal, and I want to encourage that process from happening in a natural way. And in my experience, the best way for that to occur would be to find the root issue of the problem. So if I see somebody and they have a clear digestive issue, something that is just really, you know, evident in how their skin is sort of processing whatever food or potential sensitivity that they might have, I don't necessarily want to just talk to them about upping their exfoliation and using a Clarisonic and all these great modalities that might, you know, assist the condition on a topical level. I really want to get to the issue at hand. So I ask them, what have you been eating? Have you been eating out? Have you been eating consistently? Do you feel after you eat? Do you feel like emotionally lethargic? Do you feel sort of anxious? Do you feel full and but just uncomfortable? All of those things play a huge role in how the skin is going to respond. And the skin is just actually trying to communicate to you why that's happening in the first place. So, you know, the digestion, the digestive system is a huge part of that. And that's just one example as to how all of our systems work together. I can go into further conversation with that at a further time. But to go back to how I am perceived and labeled as an esthetician, I also, you know, am so gravitated towards all of the beautiful estheticians out there that are reaching out in order to learn how to be what a therapeutic skin coach is. And for me, what I would identify as a therapeutic skin coach, how I would describe it to somebody who's not necessarily like well-versed or understands where that terminology has come from, it's just a place of continuous supportive care. There's actually this beautiful movement going on social media amongst my community of estheticians where there's this gorgeous hashtag going around where it's called Radical Facialist. And I wanted to read to you what the definition of that is. So a radical facialist, that is a person who breaks free from traditional skincare methodologies to treat skin and soul in a non-conventional way and support the self-healing of the client. That to me, if I'm going to attract any sort of attention for my therapeutic skin coach practices, I would love for it to be associated with the radical facialist movement. I find that I want to break ground with people. I want to have them accept their full self in this beautiful way. And sometimes that is moving past what's going on just physically on the skin and moving into what the emotional component of the skin condition might do for you. So I'm very honored. I'm very blessed to be a part of this movement. I feel like it's been 12 years going for me. I've always sort of spoken this language. I've always sort of spoken this type of methodology with my clients, and I'm just so grateful that people are tuning in and listening into that inner voice that is gravitating them towards that sort of care. So I hope that this helps kind of clarify any potential misconceptions or misunderstandings of what my offerings are all about. I am grateful for all of the labeling. Like, I want to be labeled as anything that is associated with a positive affirmation towards somebody's self-worth and care. I just want to be able to properly explain myself so that you know exactly where I'm coming from, where my heart is coming from, and what that terminology means to me. So thank you so much for tuning in once again, and I look forward to uploading more content for you soon, and I would love it if you would subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. So thank you, and have a beautiful, beautiful day.